was on me when I was a young parent and didn't know what I was doing at all. And she helped me to feel confident about being able to do this. Believe it or not, I was a pretty rigid, withdrawn kind of person, and stemming from my own chaotic childhood. And I just found her ideas to believe in your own ability to do things really opened up something for me. So, Carol, if you would come up and share.
Boy, did you open it up.
Thank you. But you gave me the confidence to try, you know.
I'm so glad.
I would never have been able to do that. So please welcome Carol.
Well, do you need to stand up a bit?
Yes.
Now, this is a bit funny. I do this with the children, and it's a song from the 1940s. When I was a child. And we begin by going like this, up and down with our knees. Do the huck the buck, do the huck the buck. If you don't know how to do it, boy, you're out of luck. Now throw your arms out. Roll your arms out, then you hunch your back. Give a little wiggle to your sacroiliac. Wiggle like a snake, waddle like a duck. Now you're doing the huck-a-luck.
Yeah! Just quickly, Diane is filming this. And so we are going to eventually have this available for you to watch. So don't feel like everybody has to do their camera phone. Okay?
Diane, we're going to do it a little faster now. Are you ready?
Yes.
And Dr. Gary, what is a sacroiliac?
Well, it's right back there in your spine. The bottom of your spine. That's where
right
a couple
there, okay.
Bones come together.
Are you ready? Do the huck-a-buck, do the huck-a-buck. If you don't know how to do it, boy, you're out of luck. Throw your arms out, then you hunch your back. Give a little wiggle to your sacroiliac. Wiggle like a snake, waddle like a duck. Now you're doing the huck-a-buck.
Yeah!
I'm going to tell you a little of one of my loves is employing music into stories. And we know that rhythm and repetition are the winners for children's stories. They're the ones that have gone through generations. The three pigs, the little red hen, the three billy goats gruff, the little engine that could. All of those have repetition and rhythm. And what I like to do is interject a few songs into those stories. And what I first do is tell the story without the book. And I say, and we're going to sing two songs, maybe one song if they're young children, that when we look at the book, we're going to sing these songs in the book. So there's the story of the three pigs that you all know. And there is a song that the wolf sings. And it's a clap and laugh, clap and laugh, and it goes like this. I want a big fat pig to eat. I want a big fat pig to eat. I want a big fat pig to eat. Yummy, 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 everybody. I want a big, fat pig to eat. I want a big, fat pig to eat. I want a big, fat pig to eat. Yummy, 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 Then there's the pig song. When they open the door and they see that wolf, are they going to let that wolf in?
Mm-mm.
And they go, no way, no way, no way, no way will I let you in. No way, no way, no way. Not by the hairs of my
chin.
So then, they know those songs, they're simple, and I, you know, I'm using those two songs, but you make up your own two songs, or your one song, whatever it is, and do not worry about carrying a tune. They just like rhythm. You don't even have to sing it. I want a pig, pig to eat, you know. No way, no way, no way. You don't have to sing. They like the rhythm and they like the repetition.
And so may I just say that when I sing that song, it doesn't sound like
you do. You sing very
but
well.
I mean, it's like my kids did this. You know, my kids learned this in preschool, but I have a different tune in my head, and you know what? It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't
and
matter.
And I told Sheila, almost everything goes to Skip to Malou.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Skip to Malou.
You know, so then you open the book and you tell the story, and I couldn't find my classic book of the three pigs. So here is the wolf, and the wolf notices those pigs, and he's very hungry, and he says, I want a big fat pig to eat, I want a big fat pig to eat, I want a big fat pig to eat, yummy, 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 yummy. When the pig opens the door and he sees that big fat wolf, is he going to let him in?
No.
And what does he say?
No way, no way, no way, no way will I let you in. No way, no way, no way, not by the hairs of my chinny chin chin.
So that's the three pig. And you know, those little things are repeated in the classic story. Then there's one of our books, The Little Red Hen, that you all have. And with this book, when she asks her friends, will you help me? You can say, will you help me plant the seeds now? Who will help? Who will help? Who will help me plant the seeds now? Who will help me? Who will help? Just a little song. And then this, of course, says, not I, said the rooster. Not I, not I, not I, said the
rooster.
And then, you know, all of them have different animals. And so then there's the mouse.
Not I, said the mouse.
Yeah, and then, you know, there's a cat in some. And, or you can do meow, 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 said the cat. I can't help right now. And then, bow, wow, wow, said the dog. I can't help right
now.
You know, just one or two little songs. You'll make them up yourself. You'll forget them from time to time, but it doesn't matter. And then you will be getting this book, which has so much wonderful rhyme and repetition. And so when the little goats are crossing over the smallest little goat, there's a little trip trap song, and this trip trap goes through the story itself. And you know, well, we go like this. Trip, trap, trip, trap, pitter and a patter, walking to the other side for grass to make us fatter. Trip, trap, trip, trap. Trip, trap, trip, trap.
Oh,
you can just do that kind of a thing. If you want to expand it to the troll, we beat our chest. I hear some walking on my bridge, my bridge, my bridge. I hear some walking on my bridge. I'll bet those feet are such a treat to eat. Who's that walking over my bridge? Now you can just, you know, do, who's that walking over my bridge? You know, they might just do like something like that. But you can just even eliminate it just to the trip, trap, and then when the bigger hooves come, then trip, trap, you know, with the biggest one. So this they'll be getting, right?
Right.
Yes.
That is one of the spring books. It's the last book you'll get this year.
Okay, then, The Little Engine That Could. Love this one. This has so much repetition. And the one last, if you're going to do one song, it could be I Think I Can, you know. So, I think I can, I think I can, I'll try, cause I think I can. And they love to do motions to it. I think I can, I think I can, I'll try, cause I think I can. Now, if you want to expand it, as those engines come by, the ones that don't help at all, the first one is the very shiny engine. And you go, clickety, clickety, clack, clack, clickety, clickety, clack, clack. Clickety, clickety, clack, clack, rumble and a rumble down the track. So that's shiny engine. And then comes the rusty, crusty engine. So you go clickety, clickety, squeak, squeak. Clickety, clickety, squeak, squeak. Clickety, clickety, squeak, squeak. Rumble and a rumble down the track. And then there's powerful engine. The one engine that carries all the heavy iron and big heavy things, he has a boom. So we go clickety, clickety, boom, boom. Clickety, clickety, boom, boom. Clickety, clickety, boom, boom. Rumble and a rumble down the
track.
And then when little blue engine is a little clickety, clickety, ding. Whatever, and sometimes you can use a little bell for that. You make up your own songs, but then when you read the story and you say, okay, here comes Rusty Crusty Engine, what kind of a sound does he make? And they love the little squeak sound, and you do that. But a little motion that goes with it really helps a lot. Then the gingerbread man has a lot of repetition in it. And I just have one little song where he jumps out of the engine, he jumps out of the oven, and he struts, you know, and they can get up and do that and go, hey, looky, looky, I'm a moving, grooving cookie. I can walk, jump, dance, run, gonna see the world beneath the sunny sun. Hey, looky, looky, I'm a moving, grooving cookie. So then I was looking at some of the books that we have, like I did Squirrel's Busy Day, which was one of our last ones, and I just made up a little song. I'm busy, 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 busy. I'm busy, 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 and I can't play, you know. Just something that repeated each time one of his friends said, come on, you know, come and play with us, come and talk to us. And it's not in the book, but the kids love that. Then I was even looking at another one, you know, the Bear Counts. You know, this doesn't have such a story.
Right.
But as I looked through it, and they'll all get this one.
Yes,
right?
Yes. It's in your boxes today.
There was one little thing that could potentially...
This is 3 to 5, so if you have 3 to 5,
this is 3 to 5. Is there's one little phrase here, numbers, numbers everywhere, can you count along with bear? So that, even though it's only one time there, you could repeat that and sing it. And what would you do with your hands? Numbers, numbers everywhere, can you count along with bear? Yeah, can you count along with bear? And then go one, two, you know, with each one.
I love that idea.
Yeah, I mean, just, you'll just make up your own even though it's not there. I do find, though, that telling the story before actually saying, now, here's a book. I told you the story with my mouth.
but now there are words here that are going to tell you the same story. So sometimes you don't even need a person to tell you a story, because what's going to tell you the story? And I'm just going to tell you a wonderful book that they keep asking for all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Abiyoyo. Do you know the story of Abiyoyo? It's a scary story, because in it is a giant. A giant that is so tall that he can't see way down low, and he could step on houses. Now, what's great is that this is an African folk tale. Pete Seeger tells this story on one of his old records. But in it is a song that when this giant comes named Abiyoyo, who is horrible, he never brushes his hair, so he has birds' nests in his hair, and he never washes his face, so he has yellow hair from what kind of food? And he has purple hair from what kind of food?
Grape jelly.
And red hair from what kind of food?
Strawberries.
And he has green teeth because he never
brushes his teeth.
And here's a little boy who is ostracized with his magician father. They are told to live way out in the country because they're very annoying. The little boy plays the ukulele. He annoys people, and the father makes things disappear. So he might say, oh, see that chair that Nancy is sitting on? I'm going to make it disappear. Zoop, zoop. And all of a sudden, Nancy falls on the floor. Now, was that nice? No. But here comes Abiyoyo. And the father says, we have to run. I can't do anything. He's way too up high. My magic wand can't make him disappear. And the little boy has an idea. And he runs out with his ukulele. And he says, hey, Abiyoyo, I know a song about you. And Abiyoyo says, there's no song about me. What do you mean? And he says, listen. What I love about this is that there's real music written here. So I tell them that we learn to read letters, but when you learn to play a musical instrument, this is what tells you what to play. So in the book, you know, it shows the music.
Different types of code.
A right. Different kind of code, that's right. And the little boy takes his ukulele and he sings, Abiyoyo, 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 yo 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 yo, Abiyoyo, yo 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 yo, and Abiyoyo says, hey little boy, I like that song. I really like it. It's about me. It's my name. Do it again. And then he sings it faster and faster and faster, and Abiyoyo starts dancing and dancing, and there's the music. See, so that they get to see that. And he dances so fast while the little boy's playing the ukulele. Look at him go! And of course, the kids all get up. And they say, dance like Abiyoyo. And then he trips. He begins to lose his balance. And he falls to the ground. And what can the magician do then? He can take his magic wand and he can go, and then Abiyoyo disappears. And the people in the town are so happy. They say, wonderful magician, wonderful little boy, let's have a parade. And then we get to parade all around the room, and we sing Abiyoyo. This is a great book. It's just, a lot of people don't know about it, but I love it also because it's an African-American folktale. Mm-hmm.
I was given that book when my children were young as a gift, and they loved this story. And because I don't read music, my song went Abiyoyo, 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 Abiyoyo.